Millions of years ago, all living beings that populated our planet lived in water. 30% of the known animal and vegetable species still live in these waters today. Whereas today we know much about life on land, there are instances where the sea still remains mysterious and is subsequently thought that unknown biodiversities are found within the depths. New and still evolving technologies allow the study of environments that, until yesterday, were inaccessible, such as the deepest seas, surprising with their richness, but at the same time cause major concern for their safety as they appear fragile and sensitive to the ever-growing human impact. The Department of the Territory and Environment of the Sicily Region has instituted the Observatory of the Sicilian Biodiversity. The observatory, which is aided by the CNR, ARPA, and ISPRA, has its principal objective in the realization of the cognitive base necessary for the protection and conservation of the present biodiversity. The observatory is financed by the European Funding for Regional Development, and its activities are harmonious with the National Strategy for Biodiversity. Among its missions is the exploration of life within extreme and fragile environments, perfecting safeguard systems and biodiversity studies. The marine environment is very sensitive, both to climatic impacts such as global warming, as well as impacts deriving from anthropic activities such as illegal fishing, pollution, and the introduction of non-indigenous species. The database realized by the observatory takes the census of the animal and vegetable species that have been protected or considered vulnerable by international conventions, and which live within Sicily and its waters. The activities at the observatory allow the knowledge and census taking of the different biodiversity components of Sicily. The biodiversity studies of the marine and land environments also allow the monitoring of the ecosystem's health and represent a fundamental knowledge base for sustaining the planning, programming, and territorial and environmental management of the Sicilian region. The Sicilian Technical Scientific Structure of ISPRA, the National Institute for Environmental Protection and Research, and the Institute for the Coastal Marine Environment of the CNR manage the observatory's marine aspect. ISPRA, within the observatory, has identified and georeferenced the protected animal and vegetable species, or those considered in danger by international conventions. With their own oceanographic research vessel, Astrea, it has explored still little-known environments to bring further knowledge of the island's biodiversity. Moreover, ISPRA has acquired new data on the biodiversity of protected marine areas, as well as other areas that may be safeguarded in the future. The acquired data and information are transferred to the stakeholders, to the vigilant entities, and to the public decision makers, lastly being used in the best way possible for the protection of the marine ecosystem. Research institutions, universities, protected marine areas, parks, and reserves have all collaborated with the observatory's project, allowing a network for long-term data gathering and the programming of integrated interventions, finalized in the conservation and evaluation of the Sicilian marine biodiversity. The creation of a cooperative system among these subjects will be another of the observatory's contribution until this relevant naturalistic, cultural, scientific, and economic patrimony, extremely relevant for the ecology of the entire Mediterranean, is no longer threatened. In order to raise awareness today of the biodiversity of the extreme marine environments, such as the underwater volcanoes in the Aeolian Islands and the remote seamounts of the Strait of Sicily, ISPRA has led 4 monitoring and research campaigns with the Astrea vessel, which is equipped with the most up-to-date instrumentation for non-invasive undersea investigations. Researchers used a multi-beam echo sounder, able to create extremely accurate tri-dimensional maps of the sea bottom, as well as the ROV, a wire-guided robotic vehicle that gathers high-definition images and samples up to a depth of 500 meters. The Strait of Sicily, often improperly called Channel, hides a surprising biodiversity in its numerous sea mounts, known as banks, until now relatively unknown from an ecological point of view. For divers and recreative fishermen, the banks represent a marvelous environment, but unfortunately, are often exploited by illegal fishing. Among all seamounts in the Strait of Sicily, those closest to the Sicilian coast have been investigated during research survey: Adventure Bank, Pantelleria Bank, and Graham Bank. The latter, in particular, is made up of numerous volcanic cones like that of Ferdinandea, the famous island which emerged in 1831 and had re-immersed only 6 months later. The banks are really submerged mountains of volcanic or sedimentary origin, which, starting from the depths of the continental platform, continues until a few meters from the sea surface. They are, being open sea environments, almost uncontaminated and host a surprising biodiversity. In some ways, the banks of the Strait of Sicily represent naturally protected marine areas. This has at least taken place up until now, these being sheltered from the anthropic impact such as fishing, pollution, and tourism, as well as the coastal influences such as terrigenous contributions and the nutrients transported by rivers. For this reason, they are rich with habitats and protected or threatened species, and play an important ecological role in the functioning of the entire Mediterranean. Twenty miles northeast of the Pantelleria Island lies the homonymous bank. It is a rather extended and shallow seamount. Its bottom hosts large sargasso meadows where sea bass, amberjacks, and sea breams dwell. The Adventure Bank lies only 19 miles southeast of Mazara del Vallo. The bank's shallowest part is 14 meters from the surface. For the first time in the Mediterranean, the ISPRA's submarine robot has observed large schools of common eagle rays in reproductive behavior. Thank you. bank is also populated by forests of a rare kelp, large algae found only in a few areas of the Mediterranean, and vast meadows of the seagrass Posidonia oceanica, which is the most important marine plant in the basin. The sandy bottom at the bank's margins is covered with soft coral, never before seen with such density. The Graham Bank is made up of numerous volcanic edifices, all characterized by a rich biodiversity, though different for each one of these. The more superficial areas, around 50 to 70 meters, are rich with gorgoniae. The deeper areas, starting from 100 to 150 meters, contain abundant species of rare black coral, ascidians, and soft corals. On the bank's more protected sides live the red coral, which here has particularly luminous colors, the famous Sciacca coral. The entire area is a refuge for the Haifa sea bass and the black sea bass, which move about, imposing and unmolested. At the base of the Ferdinandea, the volcanic cone which once was an island and had emerged nearly 12 miles from the city of Sciacca, is an important hydrothermal activity with gas emission and chimneys similar to those seen in the Aeolian archipelago. The principal objectives that follow the monitoring activities of the banks have been reached. The mapping of the banks through MultiBeam has been realized, and geomorphological and bionomical georeferenced maps have been obtained. The biodiversity of the single banks through visual census done with remote systems and sampling instruments have been studied. The census taking of the animal and vegetable species, as well as the protected habitats of those considered at risk by directives and international conventions such as the Habitat Directive and Barcelona Convention, has been realized. The results have proven unexpected. In these studied banks live 150 animal and vegetable species, of which 18 are protected, and 13 habitats are protected by the international conventions. The banks demonstrate precious and fragile environments that require immediate protection implements. The biodiversity in volcanic areas with active hydrothermalism is also little known today, and for this reason, these environments have been studied both in the bank areas of the Aeolian Islands and especially around the island of Panarea. The marine environments with superficial and deep hydrothermal phenomena represent certain biodiversity hotspots, but at the same time may also constitute a cause of natural alteration in the interspecies and ecosystemic marine biodiversity through the emission of contaminants. Two areas with very different volcanic and biologic characteristics among them have been studied in the waters of Panarea, one at low depth near the rock of Lisca Bianca, and the other in the eastern bottom depths of the rock of Basiluzzo. The black point, 18 meters deep, near the rock of Lisca Bianca, generated by the paroxystic emissive hydrothermal activity of 2002, around which a particularly acid environment was created, characterized by high levels of carbon dioxide, warm and rich with colloidal sulfur, upon which a strange microbial life has developed. Beyond the small island of Basiluzzo, at a depth between 80 and 300 meters, a vast area of low-temperature volcanic activity has been discovered, characterized by a succession of reddish-colored bottoms where small tube-living animals form extended facies in alternation with bioconcretions, which host brightly colored sessile species. The thinning of the natural light further distinguishes the numerous and sparse structures similar to volcanic chimneys, which rise above the sea bottom, taking characteristic shapes and colors from the ferrous and sulfuric compositions, upon which spectacular forms of life inhabit, supporting the hypothesis of a flow of energy generated by microbial activity that uses the chemical substance of volcanic origin. We are dealing with one of the deepest and most extended hydrothermal systems known in the Mediterranean. Studious crews from ISPRA, aided by colleagues from the Zoological Station of Naples, by the CNR Institute of Marine Science, and the Institute for Coastal Marine Environment, the Universities of the Marche, Messina, and Genoa, and the National Institute of Volcanology, are all studying these phenomena in what is a real and proper laboratory at sea. In the latter years, sea bottom studies have taken advantage of highly sophisticated instruments for three-dimensional mapping, such as the Echo Sounder MultiBeam. This instrument is able to project a number of highly elevated acoustic impulses on the sea bottom, measuring the depth in thousands of different points in fractions of a second, also at great distances from the ship. Elaborating and analyzing these enormous masses of gathered data, it is possible to create extremely accurate three-dimensional maps and underline the presence of any kind of structure present on the sea bottom, such as submerged mountains, rocky sandbanks, and even sunken ships. A benthic camera was used, a cylindrical-shaped device which, placed on the sea bottom, allows the measurement of all energy flows between the underground surface and the surrounding environment. This device allows an automatic gathering of unperturbed water samples, which will be analyzed in the laboratory. The camera is equipped with a multiparametric probe for the continuous monitoring of the confined water, and in particular, data gathering of temperature, pH, conductivity, dissolved oxygen, EH, or redox potential, and salinity. Moreover, numerous sediment samples have been gathered using grabs and box corers, then are analyzed in order to study the microscopic forms of life that inhabit there, such as polychaetes, small crustaceans, and mollusks. The census taking of protected and threatened species, the study of life in the banks of the Strait of Sicily, and the biodiversity of the volcanoes submerged in the Aeolian archipelago have all demonstrated that the Sicilian seas are environments rich with biodiversity, but still largely unknown and able to hide submerged patrimonies which are ecologically, naturalistically, and culturally precious, which also constitutes important economical and occupational opportunities through their eco-compatible and sustainable use. For this to come about, the biodiversity of the Sicilian seas are to be protected and defended from the thousands of threats which rise against them and which, as we have seen, have reached the maximum threshold today. The conservation of naturalistic marine patrimony will be achieved only through a project commonly shared with the other countries in the Mediterranean basin. International cooperation, which can be developed both in the field of scientific research as well as the managerial strategies of such patrimony. Therefore, today assumes a fundamental role until the protective actions taken may still prove effective and the value of the biodiversity may be preserved in a lasting manner.